We're in the vintage area with Michael Maniatis. He's the owner of a 1928 Gipsy Moth. And Michael, as people drive by this airplane, I know that I did, you look at it and you say, boy, I want to find out more about that airplane. So tell us what you've got going here.
Well, this airplane has a special history. It's a wooden Gipsy Moth. It was built very early by de Havilland. It was sold in the United States out of Lowell, Massachusetts, originally purchased by famed boat racer Gar Wood. Now, Garwood owned it for about 3 years, and then it went up to Canada and had a very interesting career up in Canada. Around 1943, it crashed in a training accident. The parts were stuffed in a barn, as usual, and resurrected in 1978. The restoration was started, got about a third of the way completed, and in 2011, the restorer, who is Watt Martin, who is actually a friend of mine, passed away. And then the plane came up to be sold around 2014, and I bought the parts. Took it home and started the restoration in 2014, so it took me about 5 years to complete it. We pretty much had to replace all the wood. Watt started with the wings, and he did a very good job replacing most of the wood on the wings. But they were uncovered, and they weren't trimmed, and we had to do all that work. And then we had to completely build the fuselage. The top decking, the front fuselage, the rear fuselage. The fuselage is built in two parts. There's a cabin and then there's a tail. And if you look closely by the design, there are fish plates, what they call fish plates, which are steel plates. They connect the two together.
What engine is in this airplane?
The engine is what's called a Gipsy 2. Now, in 1927, de Havilland decided to make a new engine for their Moths. The Gipsy 1 was 90 horsepower. This is called the Gipsy 2, and it's 120 horsepower, so it was a big upgrade. The Gipsy 1 and Gipsy 2 engines were designed as upright engines, so they had to put the thrust line lower. And then they used a long exhaust pipe to carry the exhaust away from the pilot. They're all like significant visual characteristics of this airplane, but then later on they did invert the engine in the Tiger Moth.
Tell us what it's like to fly this airplane.
Well, I can't deny that the first flight was nervous. Not that I was nervous, not that I didn't have a lot of time in these airplanes, which I do, but you have to think about you building the airplane from scratch. You want to make sure that everything's tightened and safetied and you've rigged it properly. So I was very cautious on the very first flight, a little bit nervous, but it flew really well right off the board and didn't give me any problems. But you have very limited visibility when you're taxiing or when you're first taking off. I like to get the tail up rather quickly. And then you have much better visibility. And in the air, it's fine.
How does it climb? Roll rate? Do you have any of those kinds of statistics?
Yeah, it doesn't roll that great because it only has two ailerons, but it's a real rudder airplane. You can stand this airplane on its tail, kick the rudder, it'll go right over. It likes to do loops. These planes were famous for doing what was called the bunt. When you're going forward, you push the nose straight down and go then go inverted. And the plane actually likes to be inverted, although when you get to that point, the engine stops. And then when you finally get it right side up, the engine will come back on.
Now, this airplane, the wings fold up on it on purpose. What was that design initially for?
You know, everyone was concerned about hangar space, even back in the 20s. De Havilland tried to market this airplane to as many civilians as they could. And they used to market it with pictures showing the plane being towed through the center of town. You take it out of your garage with the wings folded, you tow it to the airport, you extend the wings and you go flying. So they tried to market it so they could save people hangar rent space.
Well, Michael, it's been great talking with you. Thanks for sharing some of your airplane with us.
Thank you for letting me share it.
Aero-TV is brought to you by...
There's a difference between charting a steady course and pushing for the ceiling. And for nearly a century, Hartzell Propeller has been defining that difference. It's in our passion for engineering and research and our dedication to testing the limits of performance. We are built on honor. We are Hartzell Propeller.
There's never been a better time to become a pilot. At the Sling Pilot Academy, you can get your private, commercial, and instrument ratings in 9 months for less than $63,000 and do it in modern, fun airplanes. Your flight training is going to be as exciting as your future career as an airline pilot. SlingPilotAcademy.com.